गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर,
am I audible?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes, students, I would like to know whether I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Audible, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, audible.
Any has told that it is audible. Okay, then it's fine. We would proceed. So, students, sorry for the inconvenience that we had in the last few classes. But I think and I strongly believe also that today there will be a smooth flow till the entire class. Right. So today we will do the speaking section. Right. Open that chapter, the Word of God. Right. And okay. Yes, students, please. Then open the chapter. There we will find a debate there. Right. And always a debate has two options. We can speak either for the motion or we can speak against the motion. So here is a question on the next hours. You will get it in writing section. But this debate you don't have to say in the exam, right? You have to write only. So whatever you are supposed to speak, you will write, because it will be a writing task, right? In an exam paper also, the writing paper, there will be the question on debate, and here is an example. Right, you can come to page number 123. There you will find the debate. See the question, the alternate one in the writing section. I am reading it out. There is an ongoing debate on whether snake charmers should continue in their profession. You can get some idea about the debate from the newspaper clipping, The Hindu, 16 June 2004, given below. There is a realia, you can say, because it's a real report published in The Hindu on 16th of June 2004. The date and year is also mentioned in the bracket. You will find in the question. And had you been in the physical classroom, we could have discussed in peer work or either in group work. Some groups may have been assigned to speak for the motion. Similarly, some other group may have been assigned to speak against the motion. But here, since it is a virtual classroom, we will deal it in a practical way, in the visible way, right? So this will give us a result-oriented thing, of course, if we are not in the physical classroom. Anyway, so read it, discuss in pairs or groups, and write either for or against the profession of snake charmers, right? So it's an ongoing debate. So later, it's a report on you. It's a report writing, like in every newspaper report. You will find a title, you will find a by name, like by name refers to any staff correspondent or reporter, right? Then name of the newspaper, then place of the occurrence and the date. These are the basic components of a report writing. And report writing consists of two types, right? You can write a report for the newspaper. Similarly, you can write a report for your school magazine or for the magazine published in the club, on behalf of the club, maybe literary club, rotary club, or an eco club, whatever it may be, and you are a part of that institution. So basically, we write report for two types. One newspaper report, another is for magazines and other reports, right? Newspaper one and other than newspapers. So basically there are two reports. Here we were discussing the newspaper report, right? So it's a report writing, another part of writing section. But before this, we will discuss it in the form of a debate. And the debate is, the question is whether snake charmers should continue their profession or it should be banned. So this is the debate. You can just read the question once again, right? Just, you know, elicit some ideas. And let me tell you whatever is there in the book. And the debate says that either for or against the profession of snake charmers, as I told you, right? Let me write it on the board. So this is either or again the profession of snake charmers. So either for or against the profession of snake charmers. So students, for means you are going to support it, and against means you are going to speak against it. But whatever vote you take, whatever motion you take, either for or against, you have to put your statements, give your statements, and your statements, your words should be followed by a logic. Suppose I support this, then why should I support this? So your evidence, the data that you furnish to support your answer should be logical, should be practical. And moreover, it should be argumentative. One can argue over this. So this is the soul of a debate. Your statement should be logical, should be rational, and should be argumentative. It should create argument for the opposite parties, right, to go against you and to challenge you. Statements, but your statement should be furnished, should be designed in such a way that it should give you a logic. There are logic behind your statements and behind your words. So the beginning word in a debate should be a very fixed word, right? Like in, whenever you write an official letter or a formal letter, the format is fixed. But of course, the address will be changed, place will be changed, date will be changed, but there is a fixed format. Similarly, in speaking section, particularly in debate, there is a format, and always remember that. The first one is salutation, or you can say greeting, like good morning everyone, or good morning friends, as you see, right? So these are the initial words. The initial word is the greeting. So in every debate, the initial word is the greeting. Then, in the same paragraph, you will mention very clearly, straightforwardly, whether you are going to speak for the motion or you are going to speak against the motion. It should be stated very clearly. Many students simply, you know, escape this compulsory mark. They don't write, and it becomes difficult on the part of the examiner, the evaluator, just to extract, to get the idea whether the candidate is speaking for the motion or against the motion. So to make it very clear, very transparent, you would mention it in the introductory paragraph itself. Right, very clearly, no need to just to avoid it and to do it in an indirect way. Very directly it should be represented that good morning friends, right, good morning teachers, after greeting words, you will mention there, I am going to speak for the motion, then on the topic, that's name of the topic. Similarly, I am going to speak against the motion on the topic. Many students have ask for the attendance. Students, I will take attendance once in the middle part and once before the closure of the session. Right, so stay tuned. Right, It is for your benefit only. Teachers can take attendance using their own approach, utilizing their own methods and techniques. Right. But the purpose is your presence, your attendance. Right. Time of taking the attendance is insignificant. Significant is your marking, the presence, and staying tuned to the system, attending the classes from the beginning till the end of the class. So that should be the module. Anyway, so in the introductory paragraph itself, you would mention whether you are going to speak for the motion or against the motion, as I gave you the example. Then starts your beginning paragraph, right? Or you can say your introductory paragraph. The introductory paragraph always opens off the idea. Just like you are making an entry to any temple or any place of worship or any building or any classroom. Right? So introductory paragraph always gives you a clue of introduction. Right? So you just have to open it. You give just introductory ideas, the basic ideas, the very fundamental ideas. Right? You don't have to describe here, to write the technical details, to give the analysis. You simply write the basic details here in the introductory paragraph. Right? In the introductory paragraph. Write basic about this. Of course, if you are supporting this, the introduction should reflect that you are going to support this. Similarly, the same way, if you are going to write against it, then the introductory paragraph should reflect that this candidate is going to speak against the motion, and the introductory paragraph follows the critics. Right? And follows the introductory, the beginning part that you have mentioned in the greeting part. I am going to speak against the motion, or I am going to speak for the motion. Right? Suppose here you could have written that this snake charming is an age-old profession. Since ages, people have adopted snake charming as their profession. Right? Then you can say, provides a treatment, like one eye sees, then it's a means of livelihood. People can earn money and support their livelihood. Because snake charmers in general have no access to education, have no access to employment, no access to the basic education facilities and health facilities of life. In a way, they do not avail the basic facilities of life itself. May it be education, may it be the livelihood, may it be the food, clothes, and shelter. So it's a way to find a means to sustain on the earth, right? Similarly, there are other advantages also. Okay, that we will discuss. Yes, page number somebody has asked. It is 123, book behind textbook class 9. Students, I didn't give you the introduction, give you the hint today in the beginning of the class, because we will continue it, and it is in the continuation stage. So I didn't notify you beforehand that we are going to do this and that in the class today, because it is understood. So had I done something new, then definitely I would have informed you beforehand. Anyway, open page number 123. Right. So I gave you a few arguments that yes, it's a means of life, it's a means of entertainment. Yes, any human being on the planet barely requires a means of survival. Okay? So if survival would be there, then we would progress. First we have to survive, then we have to thrive. Right? Thrive means to progress. Anyway, so this is what I spoke a few words for the motion on the particular topic. Now I would like to give the expanded ideas, of course, with further motion, similarly, further against the motion topic. Right? Anyway, so students, now your part will be to speak for the motion. Then we will switch over against the motion side. Okay. Okay, students. You can use the audio tool, even you can use the chat box, whatever you feel convenient, right? But purpose should be one only. Yes, I am raising my hand. This is a voluntary effort. Speak for the motion, right? Anyway. Let me give you a few names, those who have not taken part yet. I am also surprised also already, then how can I award you marks without observing your participation and your contribution, right? So I think many of you, let me randomly have a quick reading, a random check that I would like to do. See. From 9th A, it is each roll number 35 present, 35, 36, 27, 28. Yes, if you are present, please put your contribution. At least a sentence or two you must write. Right, because whatever you do, we should be actively busy in the work we are doing. Right, forget about the qualitative value or the quantitative value. Right, participation is the foregrounding thing. It matters a lot. Right. Anyway, so okay. Students, let me take a surprise. Those who are attending classes and present, they can say, you can give your view that. What are the merits that you find, advantages that you find, right, for snake charming as a profession? Suppose you are telling that snake charming is a good profession, a very good profession. One should prophesize this. So if you are supporting this, means you have to say about the merits, the advantages, all good about the profession, right? Okay, here Akash has written, I am going to speak against the motion. Okay, they catch snakes for their livelihood, but they are hurting them. Okay, the snake is being harmed by some charmers. I agree, they should be educated and given job by a government, but they can do other job like this, will kill or endanger snakes. Their freedom will be lost as Wildlife Protection Act states. Yes. So Akash here included a legal point, that is Wildlife Protection Act, which forbids citizens to put any harm or to kill wild animals, including tigers, snakes, deers, bears, and all those. Right? Similarly, the onus on the part of the government to provide them job or to give them the alternative source of survival, alternative means of livelihood. Anyway, so the points are very rational actually. There are logics. Anyway, anybody else? So I would write their Akash contribution. I think 120 means 9th A or number 20. Anyway, anybody else? Neelam has written, but for their livelihood they have to do this. Okay. And snakes are being kept safe. Okay. Again, for the motion. Very good. Logical points. Aditya Maheshwari has written, good morning everyone. Yes, greeting marks the beginning part of the topic. Good one. Today I am going to speak. For the, okay, see, here you have written for or against. No, you speak either for or against, not both. Because debate doesn't give you to speak both. It is either or, right? To speak for the profession of, so let me read it so that I can know whether it is for or against, okay? Snake charming is a traditional practice, but it's a very bad practice, okay? So it is against the motion. So you should have written here, I am going to speak against the motion. Very straightforward reason. I am going to speak against the motion. Right.
I'm grateful to speak against God. I'm going to speak against the motion. Okay. Then they have to do that, okay, to save their livelihood, they keep snakes safe. Then they have to do that to save their livelihood, okay. Aryan has also made the same statement. They don't like stay in a prison, okay. They can do other job, they should be educated and trained for doing varieties of job. They can make researchers of plants, etc. without harming animals, they feel in danger. Yes. See, snake charmers prepare herbal medicines which are useful as anti-venom. Very practical question and logic. See, anti-venom injections or medicines are scarcely available. So much probability lies that a patient dies, the affected person, victim of snake biting, dies, loses the life. Reason being, non-availability of anti-venom injection. But snake charmers who are very closely associated with the herbal plants, they prepare anti-venom medicine. Even they can guide others how to prepare those. They can save the lives of others. Right? Anyway, Indian lithosphere or even our domestic surroundings, our residences are often snake prone. Most of the area you can take into account. Okay. Then Mohini has written, not for or against, either for or against. Anyway, I have made it clear also. Then let me switch over to other contribution. It is Hardik is written, I want to speak for the motion. Very good. It is very clear, very short and sweet, simple also. Snake charmers, right from the past, have entertained us. Yes, big source of entertainment. It's a livelihood, second logic. Snakes are not harmed, so there is no provision of going against wildlife acts. Yes, they are being taken care of. Very strong logic you have. Also help to exclude snakes from our houses safely without causing damage to the snake. Yes, very simple, but the points are solid. You can say hard solid, hard rock points. Very difficult to challenge those. So such topics become very difficult for the opposite parties to challenge this, because these are quite, you know, 100% truthfulness you can find here. It's very difficult to challenge those. Right? So in one paragraph he has consolidated. Brilliant piece of example, Hardik. Thank you so much. And each of his statements are being given logic. It has been proved. Right? Every statement he has provided, he has mentioned, and it is supported by logic, evidence. Right? So this is very concrete example that you are putting statements at the same time. You are going to put evidence, right? Brilliant piece of writing. Thank you so much. Anyway, now our part will be against the motion. Now you will speak all against it, all demerits, all bad, all disadvantages. You mention in your statements, in your answer. Anyway, see, just I am going to give you a clue before going to the other part, that is against the motion part. See, Akash Bijan has given the example that if snake charming is a means of livelihood, then this livelihood which is harmful can be stopped. And of course, if one person is going to lose the means of livelihood, then he will be provided another means of livelihood. That means government should provide them job, the works, so that he can do, the snake charmers can do physical work, the manual work, and can earn his livelihood. Brilliant example. Whatever you speak, you have supported the evidence, the arguments you have formed. Yes. Because if I, how can I put harm to anybody's means of livelihood? If I am going to take it, then something must be given to him, so that I can take something from him. Anyway,
Very logical. Jaya Panchal has written, I will speak for the topic, they case the poisonous snake so that they didn't harm us. Yes. Earlier also we found this. I am going to speak against the motion. Let me read it. They pet snake because they are uneducated, they don't have any other profession, so they charm snakes. Yes, absolutely correct. But for protection, they also bring teeth up. Teeth itself is plural, no need to add S. Of snakes for protection from poison, which we can say that they are harming the snake, so this is not good. What I think is that they should educate their children so that their children will do other good job. Anyway, children's again, children itself is a plural, like science children, like no need to add S. Anyway, so besides the grammatical error, all go well. Anyway, then Parth has written, let me read this. Yes, as we all know, it looks very good when we see snake charmers with their snakes. People enjoy it a lot, but we should also think about that snake. They have to live inside a small box. Yes, it is harm against their freedom. Yes. Animals also have feelings. Absolutely correct. They also want to be free and they love independence, whereas on other side, snake charmers also sometimes saves life of the people who got bitten by the snake. By okay, students, Parth Saini has just mixed it in a debate. You can't merge the ideas. You can't go both. This is either or. Yeah, Parth Saini, just to take in your language, right? Either speak for the motion or against the motion. Not both. Not mingled. Not combined. Yes, do not take an integrated approach. It's very straightforward. Yes, either or. No merge, no mixing, right? No inclusion. Anyway, you write less, but it should be pinpointed. It should follow a symmetry, right? Anyway, Garvit has written, I am going to speak for the motion, okay? Because deforestation is happening in a large scale, so snakes' habitats are decreasing. So educated snake charmers can take care of snakes, which will keep alive both snake as well as snake charmers. Solid rock, rock solid you can say. Very technical issue. He has interpreted the same thing in an indirect way. Like some students ask, sir, government is forbidding us not to cut trees. फिर अगर पेड़ नहीं काटेंगे तो ये पेपर कहाँ से बनेगा? अगर पेपर नहीं बनेगा तो हम पढ़ाई कैसे करेंगे? लिखेंगे कहाँ से? Yes, one problem gives birth, generates so many problems, right? So if we don't cut trees, how can we prepare the paper? And in the absence of the paper, how can we read? How can we write? How can the office function? Right? So very technical glitch, he has discovered it and he has pinpointed it. Thank you so much. Brilliant piece of writing. Then Mohini has written, I am going to speak against the motion. Snake charmers, they catch snakes for their livelihood, but they are hurting it. Yes, they exclude the snakes from our house. Anyway, I thought that we have to write a paragraph on snake charmers, so I wrote both sides. No, you don't have to write both, you don't have to merge it, you don't have to combine it. No, zero tolerance to this. Not at all. Yes, this is either mushroom or paneer, not both. You take it in that way. You have to take either mushroom or paneer. You don't have to take both. So this is the clause. If you come to this cafeteria or this hotel or this restaurant, you have to follow a system. And the system is not both but any one. This is debate in very simple sense. Yes, not paneer and mushroom both, but either paneer or mushroom. Yes, this is debate. Okay. Anyway, so yes, I would like to get a few answers against the motion because the quantity is imbalanced now. If you want to make an equivalent, you know, parity or uniformity, if you want to have, then I would like to get a few answers in respect of against the motion. Then I will give my own views in regard. Even you can question me, you can interrupt me, you can challenge me. That I always welcome. Okay. Then also we will have a debate between you and me. Anyway, yes, anybody else? Virendra Mina has written. Very good, Virendra. Good initiative. Everyone, I am going to speak again. Both Paneer and Masroor. Either Paneer or Masroor. This restaurant doesn't give you both. The menu strictly forbids you to take both. Yes, this is either or. This is either or. Yes. So, Virendra, can you just make a twist, make a slight variation or change to your statement? Okay. Again, Akash has written, though they save life, snakes can't be kept. To leap is open is happier than to leap inside a basket. Wonderful statements. They can take medicines but not keep snakes for its entire life. It should be given freedom. Snakes can live in desert, forest, water, etc. So there are many places. Yes. If you conserve snakes, then keeping it inside the box or inside the basket is not necessary. It's a harm. We are harming it on the pretext of or in the disguise of protecting it. Right? Anyway, so it should be provided its natural habitat. Because any living organism, may it be human being, may it be snakes, or may it be any plants, any animals, any bird you can say, it lives well, it grows well in its natural habitat. If you put it in artificial habitat, then it doesn't grow well. Its freedom is just seized, taken away, it's killed. Yes? So how can you bring a polar bear, for example, the bear that grows up in polar region, where there is more cool, extreme cool, and how can you bring it to the deserts of Jaisalmer in Rajasthan? It will simply die. And you can't say that, yes, I'm going to do something extraordinary, I'm going to do something uncommon, right, an extraordinary one, is a genius, and I'm taking the polar bear and growing it off in the deserts of Rajasthan in order to create a record, maybe to put my name in Limca Book of Record, but it's simply a harm, right? So in order to do a record, you create a wonder, you can't break a system. That is what, Akash has written in his statements. In order to create a record and to make a wonder, you can't break a chain, a natural chain, and you can't put someone to death. Yes, Bhavya has written, but if they don't keep snakes in baskets, how can they carry them? Yes. Right. If I am your opponent, then I could have argued you that yes, snakes can't be kept in basket. Yes, it's absolutely true, my dear participant, my dear opponent. But at the same time, it can be kept in the zoo, in the sanctuary, where you can find snakes also, of course, in the different zone, but in the same surrounding where other animals, other wild animals like the wild birds, the bears, the tigers and others are there. Right. Anyway, Lakshita has written, good morning everyone. Yes, good one. Begins with an introductory word, that is greeting. I am going to speak against the profession of snake charmers. Correct one. No confusion. Simply straightforward, 100% correct. In the beginning part, she has mentioned whether she is, what she is going to speak about. It's a very bad practice, yes. Pehle se unhone attack kiya, because it harms the snakes, absolutely correct. They also have right to freedom, yes, supporting the statement. Sorry, going against it and making the evidence. They love independence, yes, so they should not be kept in the baskets, right. Anyway, Aditya has written, capturing snakes disturb the food chain also. Good one. Very technical issues. It disturbs, it hampers the food chain and the food wave. Right? Anyway. Students, in the last Sunday issue, in the Economics Times, there was an article published on deer hunting. Yes, what was the reason? The kings and the Maharajas used to kill the deers. And its mythological connection also he has built up. Right? Because had the deer not been chased by Lord Ram, then Ravan could not have been killed. So to kill Ravan, the deer hunting just lays the foundation stone, because Ram went to chase the deer, then in his absence Ravan came, and subsequently the Ramayana story goes, and which leads to the, and which ends in the death of Ravan. So deer hunting was good, what the article writer has put his treatments. His name is Devdutt Patnaik, very famous writer. Even you can also search it in the Indian Express, sorry, the Economics Times column on Devdutt Patnaik. Suppose this Sunday was 13, right? Then it is next 7 days, means on 6th of December. You can search on the web, there you will find a beautiful piece of writing. The mythological connection and the practical connection, the scientific spirit and mythological spirit. Good combination is there. Okay. We also live in protected house and forest and not in the original habitat. Snakes are kept in baskets for a short period of time. Okay, anyway. So a good number of examples that we discussed today. But I would like to see a few friends of mine to come back and mark your presence. Earlier you were 49, now you are 40. You are going to put self-harm. Like in the ongoing topic of discussion reflects this. It says this. Right? This is self-harm. You were present in the beginning, took part in the ongoing question answer session, but in the end, this is a self-harm. Simply it is erosion, just like soil erosion. Please mark your attendance, tell your friends. You can call them, those who had joined in the beginning but not now. Yes, marking presence and attendance is very crucial. Anyway. Students, please mark your presence. Yes, after a few minutes, I will take your attendance. At least call them, those who were present in the system, but not now. It is a self-loss. And Indians don't go for self-loss. Always, we should be in an advantageous position. Of course, not by harming anyone, anyway. So students, if you say that, if I say against the motion, then I can say, suppose if it is a means of survival, then you can't give anybody a chance to take a means of survival by killing others. The self-survival doesn't mean to kill others, the destruction of others. Like Akash has written, means of livelihood can be provided by the government. I mean to say, the alternative means of survival should be provided by the government, like the 100 days work, right? Mahatma Gandhi, 100 days work, like MGNREGA, National Rural Employment Guarantee Program. Mahatma Gandhi, National Rural Employment Guarantee Program, MGNREGA, it is Act also, Employment Guarantee Act. Similarly, some other works are there, like Food for Work. So people can be given a chance to earn their livelihood, to do 8 hours of work. If they are not skilled, then they can work in a manual way and they can earn their livelihood. Right. Second, it's a means of entertainment. If anybody who wants to speak for the motion says that it's a means of entertainment, then my point will be that how can you take anything as a means of entertainment by killing others, by harming others? You can't put somebody inside the basket and show to others that it's a means of entertainment. It can dance at the stroke of your sound. It can sing at the stroke of your clap. No, it simply goes against human rights. Similarly, animals' rights. Yes. Suppose my opponent says that yes, it's a message. It's a very clear message to protect the wild animals, to make a balance. Like the balance of environment, I would say the balance between the flora and fauna. Then you can say, how can you go for the balance of the environment
by changing one animal's natural habitat. If it grows well in its natural habitat, in the jungle, in the forest, right, collecting its food in its own way, right, living its life with freedom in its own way, then how can you bring someone from the jungle, from its natural habitat, and you grow up inside your home? It is simply you are going to kill the freedom. So it can't be a message for the protection of wild animals. It's simply wrong. Right? So debate goes on in a very interesting way. Whatever your opponent will speak, you should have the ability to challenge him with your words and with your logic. Yes? Similarly, you put some words either against the motion or speak the motion and put me in the challenging mood. I will test myself whether I am able enough to challenge your statements. Right? Okay. Students, you can ask me questions. Suppose I am on the one hand and you are on the other hand. If you will put me to make my own logic against the motion, then also I am ready. If you will put me giving your questions and to give my arguments, if you invite my arguments, so I can speak for the motion, if you will speak against the motion. And similarly, the vice versa. Yes. So I am welcoming some of you to put your own question, to put your own logic. Right? Anyway. Okay. Yes, they can keep them in a type of case like, okay. Students, can anyone put me in the question zone? Suppose you put your own logic and put me questions. Okay, because debating is always an exchange of ideas, right? It's a sharing of ideas. Anyway, students, can anybody put your view? Okay, Aditya has written, employment is needed and we know the rate of employment is very less. Okay. Aditya, are you going to put me this question or simply it is your view? We also live in protected houses and not in the original habitat, that is forest. Snakes are kept in baskets for a short period of time, for example, to sleep comfortably in baskets. Yes, brilliant question. So my logic towards Hardik would be that yes, you are correct. Since ages, 100 years before, thousands of years before, human beings used to live in the forest. That's good. Yes, you are correct, 100% correct. But my logic to your argument would be that human being always needs an evolution. Like you can talk about the natural evolution propounded by Charles Darwin, right? The Origin of Species and his famous book. Right? Like the living organism came in the form of a jelly, like the jellyfish. It got created in the water, then the survival evolved. Right? So human survival and human existence is always an evolution. That's good. Yes. But if you change my evolution pattern, my living pattern, my living place from forest to this well-civilized place, the non-forest zone, then I am growing here well. I am progressing at a good pace. I am learning new things. Yes, my pace of advancement is good enough. But if you take the other one, if you take the other case, then if you shift the habitat of the snake from the forest to your home, right, then it's a loss. In no way the snake is exhibiting its best. Like it is contributing its best towards the balance of environment, towards the food chain and food web in the forest, but simply it is degrading. The forest witnesses a loss. So if you are changing its habitat, the natural habitat from forest to the home, then it's a loss, both for the snake and for the jungle also, and for the human beings also, because human being survival and progress depends upon the natural habitat.
And if the natural habitat is get affected in a bad way, similarly, human beings also get affected in a bad way, adversely affected, what you say. Anyway, then again, he has put his logic. Let me read those. Sir, but snakes also helps in farming by eating some rodents. Then why snake charmer should be there? But they should also be there to protect people from snakes. Anyway, right. So it's always a ratio proportion, right? So if you take about a symmetry in mathematical sense, or if you take into account the ratio and proportion, then protection or giving protection to human beings against snakes by snakes themselves, the ratio proportion is very less. It will never achieve even a single full digit. It is always be in fraction and decimal, minus more. But if you think in the other way, in the opposite way of what you are going to speak, then the snakes could have contributed by residing in its own land, the natural habitat, in a big way. Right? So the ratio proportion is never achieved. It is highly, highly improportionate. Anyway, let me see another question if anybody has. We should do according to the present situation and past, there were poachings, but now it's not good. Yes. Poaching of wild animals is always a crime. It's a non-bailable offense. You can talk about the Bollywood actor Salman Khan's incidents, right? The case is yet pending, it's not been finalized. We should do according to the present situation and past, there were poachings. Yes, poaching is always a crime. In the past, it was very relaxed actually. The norm was not so strict as it is now. Okay. So students, I have also other classes, so I should leave it. Right? And this much for today, let me take the attendance. Starting from 9th A, 1 to 4 absent, then 5 present, 6 is absent, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 is absent,
sir,
then 18 present, 19 is absent,
sir,
then 21, 23 absent here, then 24, 25 present, 26, 27 absent, 28 present, 29, 30 absent, then 31 present, 32, 33 absent, 34, 35 present, 36 absent, then 37 present, then 1, 2 present, then 3, 4 from 9th B absent, then 5, 6 present, 7, 8 absent, roll number 9 present, 10 is absent, 11 present, 12, 13 absent, then 14 present, 15 present, 16 is absent, then 17, 18 present, 19 is absent, then 20 present, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 absent, 28 present, then long gap, 29 to 35, 7 students, then 36 absent, 37 present, okay. Thank you students.
Sir, roll number 8 is present.